Here is the response from a general get method. The response is not a good one. It certainly doesn't fulfill the constraints of a truly RESTful API, where a response should be a self-descriptive. So what we are going to do in this video? Provide better responses. And we start with a get request, where we get all the products. And we can improve it, because here we clearly get a response, which is interesting to us. It gives us all the IDs, and we know that we can take an ID and append it at the end of the URL to get the data from this object. But this is not necessarily something you know when you're a newcomer to this API. So it would be nice if we also provide a link here, which then could be programmatically fetched to send another request. And maybe we also want to send some metadata, like the number of products we fetch. So here in the controller, I don't want to just return the products as a response. I want to return more. Before we start, let's add a separate namespace for our descriptive responses. Let's name it output. Here we will store a representation of our responses. Inside, create a new class product. It will be a representation of a single product. It contains an ID, name, and the price. Initialize these fields. And make the properties public. I want to force consumers of this class to instantiate it only from the real product. So we can make the constructor private and create a new static one. Name it from entity.
Use product ID, name, and price. Add an alias product entity.
Okay, go back to the controller and update mapProducts method. Instead of returning a list of arrays, we return a list of responses. Let's make an alias output. At this moment, the response structure is still the same. Let's make it more self-descriptive. We can start with a plain array. It has keys, products, and count. Nice, let's see it in action. Save that and send again a get request to get all products. Now this is our new response. We get an object with count 2 and the list of products. Then, as I said, it would be interesting to have more information on the individual product, like the URL to the detailed information of that product. So for that, we can create a new representation object request. It will be embedded in product representation. It contains a type of the request and URL. We can make the constructor private and provide use cases by explicit secondary constructors. Now I want to provide information about what kind of request do you have to send to what URL to get more information about the individual product. So here it is a GET request that should be sent to a given URL. Now it is the URL of our server. In our case it is localhost 8000. But of course you can dynamically fetch it. And then we have products slash with product ID. Let's extract a constant here. Done. Move back to product and update it. Add a new property request. Update the primary constructor and the secondary one. In the controller, provide a call of request detailed product with an ID of the entity. done. And if I send this and send a GET request, we get back this extra information with the URL where we can get detailed information of that given object. So this is now how we should structure our responses. And of course you can structure them according to your needs. Now let's have a look at other routes. If we created a new product, I simply return now an array of product attributes. Instead, I also want to provide a link to get information about the created product. So we import product representation class and use it with alias output. Then, when the product was stored, let's build an array with key product. Here we also provide a request for detailed information about a created product. So this would now be a better response for creating a new product. If we have a look, send a request to create a new product. This looks good. Next, we can do the same for other routes. Like here, when we get data about one single product. Open the controller and import product representation with an alias. Build a response array. Key product, and here I want to provide a link to update product endpoint. Let's create a request for it. Add a new static constructor, update product. Inside, we send a put request to this URL. Done. Then in response, let's add one more request with a link to a list of all products. Again, open a request and add a new static constructor, list products. A GET request to our general URL. Add this new request and replace product as array with our response. Why I'm doing all of this? You should always keep in mind that for public APIs, for APIs that are used by other people, it should be clear how to use it. Thus, it should contain self-descriptive responses. Let's also do the same for updating. Here, right now, we return nothing. Let's return a request saying that you can send a GET request to get the details about the changed product. Inject ID into the closure and cast it to an integer. Change no content response to 200 OK. That would be a meaningful response for updating. Let's try this out. If I want to send a put request to this URL, I get back this updated response. And with that, for a delete request, we also can return something meaningful. Here I can't send a link to a product because it was deleted. But instead, let's return a request object with saying that, hey, you can send this request to create a new product. Let's create a static constructor for it. Name it createProduct. Inside, we use a post request to our general URL. But it is not complete here. This request object doesn't say anything about the data we need to send to create a new product. So let's update the request object and add a new property, body. Make it public. Then in our request for product creation, we can say that this request accepts a name, which is a string, and a price, which is a float. Return this new request in the controller. Now, if we save this and we delete a product here, we get back this link which says that we can send a post request to this URL And if we pass this payload, then we will create a new product. So these are more meaningful responses. I think that we have spent enough time on that. Oh, and now we can remove this toArray method. We don't need it anymore.